I have been getting a ton of questions asking me how to reduce fibromyalgia flares. I'm going to answer that question in just a moment.
Dr. Mark Dailey is president and CEO of Birmingham Functional Medicine, founder of Fibromyalgia University, a certified functional medicine practitioner, and a nutritional counselor with advanced education in functional endocrinology, functional blood chemistry, the brain and neurotransmitters, and thyroid function. With over 25 years in clinical practice, he focuses on chronic conditions like fibromyalgia, chronic fatigue syndrome, irritable bowel syndrome, as well as autoimmune conditions. Let me introduce Dr. Mark Dailey.
Anything that activates the immune system can cause a fibromyalgia flare-up. These aggravating factors can range from food sensitivities, yeast overgrowth, parasites, environmental pollution, toxic metals, even emotional triggers, and there's a lot more. The more you can reduce these elements, no matter what they are, whether it's dairy, corn, soy, wheat, household products, or environmental pollutants, the fewer and the less severe these flare-ups are going to be. So that's a really simple concept, but don't take it lightly because it's really, really important. The more we can reduce your exposure and calm your immune system, the fewer fibro flares you will have. With that in mind, one of the solutions to your fibromyalgia flares is to find out what your major underlying triggers are. Food sensitivities are always part of the problem. Now, there are other tests that we do for environmental toxicity, heavy metal toxicity. We're able to look for parasites and bacterial dysbiosis using lab tests, but I can't cover all that today. So I want to share what we commonly find in the fibromyalgia patients, and food sensitivities, as I mentioned, are always part of that problem.
Okay, very briefly, I want to review a sample food sensitivity test with you. As you can see here, IgG food allergy test. Remember, this is really food sensitivities in the respect that it's not like an allergy where you eat a peanut and your throat closes off right away. These are often delayed, and that's what makes it hard to differentiate. So we're looking here at dairy, legumes, fruit, and where the line is extended, these are areas of sensitivity. Now, most of you probably won't get a test result like this because you see there are so many in the dairy, although that's not uncommon. You see the legumes, see the fruits that people are responding to, and of course, this is simply a sample, but how important would it be to know what foods you're actually reacting to? You see here meat and nuts and seeds. Something I like a lot about this too, it not only does it look at nuts and seeds, but vegetables that you may be responding to. But something I often see, and I'm thankful they have on this report, is yeast overgrowth. And many of you have probably considered this. So food sensitivities are an issue because it causes your immune system to respond and literally attack food molecules. But something that a lot of people have growing in their gastrointestinal system is candida albicans. And that is a big issue. And then in line with that, we see that this person also responds to yeast. So many of these foods would throw this individual into a flare-up. So once you know the foods that you are responding to, you can remove them from your diet, minimize the aggravating factors from an immune system point of view, and reduce your fibromyalgia flares.
Something that is very interesting that I want to share is that test is done in your home. You actually just prick your finger and put a few drops of blood on a lab panel, and then send it back to the laboratory. So that can be done without leaving your house. It gives you a ton of information and will really help you reduce fibromyalgia flares. So before I wrap up, I want to talk about how and why food aggravates the immune system in many cases. If you'll look here, you may notice this is actually a slide of your gut lining. So the gut lining has these little junctions in them. And what happens is food moves from your gastrointestinal system through these junctions and make their way to your blood. Now, when you have something like leaky gut syndrome, which is also called hyperpermeability, larger than normal molecules slip from the blood into your from your gut into your blood, and they can cause an immune reaction. That causes systemic inflammation, and that in part is why you have these flare-ups. So we definitely want to avoid that. Bottom line is the immune system activity causes inflammation, body-wide pain, and stiffness. This is often called a fibromyalgia flare. So removing more of these offenders reduces the pain, fatigue, and brain fog. And of course, that's where you want to be. So if you want some help with these lab tests or want to know how our program works and some of the other testing that we do, you're welcome to go to this website, www.beatingfibro.com. I've got a bunch of information on that page, and I think it will be really helpful. But thanks for your time. Have a great day. I hope this is helpful. As you can see, if you want to reduce fibromyalgia flares, you have to reduce the physiological burden on your body. One of the ways that we do this, and what we're talking about today, is food sensitivities. This is a very, very helpful test. If I can be of any help to you, if you would like to order the test through me, not only will I make sure you get the test kit sent to your home, I will actually review the results with you and give you an idea how you might use that information to reduce fibromyalgia flares. If this has been helpful to you, please like the video, subscribe to the channel. We put these videos out once a week, and hopefully they'll be a benefit to you. Thanks so much, and have a great day.
If you are struggling with a chronic condition and would like more information, feel free to visit www.birminghamfunctionalmedicine.com. You are also welcome to set up a phone or Zoom consultation with Dr. Dailey at www.talktodrd.com.